5th of April 2018.
This is a 13-year-old male, not Newton Jack Russell. He came in today because he's not eating, right? For 4 days, right? Oh. So general physical examination, you can see that you check the legs, you look at the legs. There seems to be some swelling. Huh? But it's not obvious here. Not obvious. Left or right now. Just focus on it now. It's not so bad. Pause alright. It's further up here. Now the owner has examined the dog also, and he can feel some swelling here, which is actually fluid. Subcutaneous fluid come this side, you can see. You can feel this part is a bit more swollen compared to this part. This part you can feel the ribcage. This part you cannot feel the ribcage. These are the fluid swelling. And then the obvious one is here. You can see the hock. Hock is swollen. About 4 times the size of the normal one, the right one. The left one is swollen. And we turn a bit this side, you can see. Okay, painful. It's painful. So we got the x-ray now. Now x-ray was in March 8th. On March the 8th, the x-ray was done. And you can not see the lung tissue so clearly. So there's fluid edema. And this part is a mess here. So let me see. You can see the heart is enlarged, but it's all not clear because of the fluid. And there's some tumors. So the dog had breathing difficulty. Not any breathing difficulty? Difficulty in breathing?
Breathe very hard long times. You can hear when he's sleeping.
Mm. So I was saying that it's a right lung tumor, but actually they are both sides. Now you look at the ventral dorsal view. The ventral dorsal view, this side is more obvious, the right side. But actually the left side, there's one here. So that was in January. So January is not so bad. January wasn't so bad. You can still see the lung tissues. There are more lung tissues. But the right side, definitely there is a tumor here. The heart, you cannot see clearly, but you can still see roughly. So that's January. Then we look at the March one. The March one will be here. Okay, this is March. March is definitely, the x-ray is a better x-ray. But you can see the tumor here. And actually, there's another tumor here. From here to here. These are the lung tumors. Either they are from the heart, the pericardium side, the heart tumor. But anyway, you can see that this heart is not, you can't see the shape of the heart. So the tumors are here, here, on the right side, and the left side is more on the posterior part. Now, compared to a normal dog, this is a normal dog, although it's a puppy. It's a puppy, but roughly the same. It's in a normal dog, you will see that the lung tissue is black. Now this dog has kind of coughing, so the lung is not black, not fully black. But you can still see the air inside the lungs on the left side and on the right side. You can see very clearly there, the air black, and then here also should be black. And the outline of the heart is clearly seen. See? Now this is a normal heart here. You can see the globular shape of the heart. And the lungs, normally about 2/3 of the chest cavity, the pleural cavity, and then this side also 2/3 of the lungs, the normal lungs. Okay, so you can see that roughly this is the normal one, and the abnormal one will be what we saw just now, this dog, this Jack Russell. And you can see I've done some arrows here, but these are tumors here, tumors here, and I should have put an arrow here as well, tumors here. So
that results in the swelling, okay, of the, in this case it's the left side, because the left side is more
obstruction of the blood flow. The left side is obstruction of the blood flow, so there's swelling here, and mainly here, and obvious here. So we will give the drug to bring down the water in the tissues, and we give a drip and an injection first. Okay, finish.